There's a girl who sits under the bleachers, just another day eating alone. And though she smiles,
I just remember it really well because some of the words they would just say were like really harsh and cruel for like our age.
It really just boiled down to it was me, you know, making fun of kids, teasing kids, and just putting them down for little things that they would do.
You're fat, you're mature, you don't have boobs yet, like no boy wants to date you. She would like say things even when I would pass by and like laugh. But one day like wrote a note and it's like, Carly's a bitch, she only talks about shit, she's a hoe, we wouldn't care, she would go. Like it was like a poem there, it was so ridiculous. And then the thing that like got me the most is like at the bottom they wrote, these are a list of all the girls that agree with us, and they had them like sign it. But the worst part was like they were girls I didn't even know, like someone went to a different school district. So that like really got to me.
Take another look at the face of Miss Owens, invisible. Look a little closer and maybe then you will see.
Definitely can think of one example where I just happened to drop my stuff in the hallway one time, and a lot of people just walked by, and I think it's that that really passive approach to it that really people don't realize can be, well, not that people were making fun of me for dropping my stuff, but it'd be nice for someone to, you know, help out. So this one time I dropped my things and this kid stopped, and I didn't really know him that well, but I talked to him a couple times and he helped me pick up my books and my papers and everything, and I thanked him and he went on his way. And he probably never even remember that instance, but when I think of that guy, I'll just always think he was the nice guy to, you know, stop and help me out. So.
All of the research and everything that I've acquired without the research and my being in the trenches for 22 years has proven that the only way to stop the bullying is to get the bystanders involved. There's always going to be a victim. There'll always be a target for the bully to get to. It's never going to stop. That's a dynamic that's been around since cave people were walking around on the planet. So the only way to stop that or make it accountable is for the people that are on the outside to watch, to get involved, to have the courage to balance it out and say, do I want to take the risk of stepping forward and doing what I know is right with the possibility I may end up being bullied or I may end up getting hurt? And they have to make that balance.
And this isn't the end of the tunnel when these bullies, you know, confront you. And just keep pushing through it and, you know, have a smile on your face and, you know that this isn't the end and that there are other people around you who want to be your friend and want to help you. If you're not afraid to open up and talk to people and not let the fear of, you know, opening up to other people grip you and just let go of that fear, then you can really find people who really do want to help you.
And the more that they joked and the more that they screamed, she retreated to where